do think that there is a risk, because we know this is a red line for for China, that you could force, you know, Beijing to crack down further on free speech in Hong Kong?
Well, it's not. I think we cannot decide whether what we should say or what we should not say just based on some so-called political red lines. I cannot see anything I've said contradict the existing laws of Hong Kong. And if Beijing or the Communist Party wants to limit more the Hong Kong people's freedom, they can use all kinds of excuses. And now I may be just taking it as a kind of scapegoat and use, I was being used to justify in the future for a stricter limitation on people's right to express in Hong Kong.
反政治成功以后，我们要建立这个民主的。所以在中国大陆现在的不同的族群啊，可能包括上海的族群呢，也可以决定啊，我是不是应该成为一个用什么关系大家联系在一起？我们可以考内成为独立的国家，我们可以考内成为一个联邦的一个部分，我们也可以考虑好像欧盟那种邦联的一个部分。
Beijing started to draw so-called the red lines one by one. First, if you advocate independence explicitly, then you will be disqualified from running in the in the election. Then in the recent by-election, if you are talking about self-determination and there will be a referendum including independence as an option, the red line is drawn. You cannot say such thing and you will be disqualified. And now my case is that, well, just talk about the possibility in the future, not talking about anything immediate, no concrete action. It's just about about thinking about the future. And if the future includes a possibility of independence, then you will again be, say, crossing the red line. Now, if Beijing wants to do that, actually it doesn't depend on who say the matter. But I'm just taking as I say, the scapegoat for all of it.